Now, doesn't that music just give you goosebumps every time you hear it? I mean, it does to me, but that's besides the point. But anyways, as the opening crawl said, today's topic is Star Wars. Star Wars, Star Wars, Star Wars. You know, yesterday was May the 4th. So, you know, May the 4th be with you, May the Force be with you, if you never got what it means for May the 4th. But yesterday was, you know, Star Wars Day. So Star Wars to me is just, I love it. It's one of my favorite movies of all times. It's my favorite saga of all time. I don't care if you like Harry Potter, Lord of the Rings, doesn't matter. Star Wars is better than them all. If you want to fight about it, we can. I don't care what you say. Star Wars is the best saga of all time. So in this blog, we're going to talk about what I like about Star Wars. I will list my favorite from my favorite Star Wars movie to the least favorite. It doesn't matter. It's all Star Wars to me, so I still love every bit of it. Even so much as I've seen Phantom Menace 12 times in theaters. Like, that's crazy. That was back in 1999 when, you know, ticket prices were like $1.25 to go to a movie. It was crazy. It was great times back then. I don't know how much ticket prices cost. But yeah, so I've seen Phantom Menace 12 times in theaters, countless times on VHS, countless times on DVD and Blu-ray. So even the worst of the Star Wars movies, I've seen plenty of times. So let's get to it. Let's talk about Star Wars. Now, I love everything about Star Wars. Love everything from the characters, the story, the special effects, the music. The music is so iconic. There's very few movies out there that have such an iconic theme or song selection that you can just immediately think of, you know, a Star Wars character. So, I mean, you have the opening thing when you see the opening crawl like we did earlier. Like, da-da-da-da-da. Like, come on. I mean, there's nothing more iconic than that. Then you have even Darth Vader's theme song. I mean, the man himself has his own theme song that is called the Imperial March. And anytime you just hear it, you automatically think of Darth Vader. See what I mean? Iconic. Very few villains have their own theme that's so powerful and catchy and it's stuck in your head. And when you want to feel like, you know, you're on top of the world, you just start humming it. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, no, I did it. Yes, I brought back the Darth Vader mask. I had to come back, especially for this one because of Star Wars. Hold on a second. I'm getting a message. Let's see here.
Help me, Robert Butler. You're my only hope.
All right, we're just going to ignore that message and get back to the blog. All right, now I want to talk about my favorite Star Wars movies from my least favorite all the way to my top favorites. So we're going to start off with my least favorite Star Wars movie, which is The Phantom Menace. Yeah, as much as I love Darth Maul, as much as he kicked butt in that movie, as much as I love the double-bladed lightsaber, yeah, still's no excuse for Jar Jar. Jar Jar is possibly the worst addition ever to Star Wars. Star Wars The Phantom Menace Episode 1 is not my favorite one at all. My second least favorite Star Wars movie is Attack of the Clones. A lot of it has to deal with, you know, Anakin and Padme. That love story is more wooden than Pinocchio before he came to life as a boy. And, you know, it just didn't really mesh. But the ending scene with Geonosis was pretty cool. You know, the arena and then Yoda fighting. I mean, that's just boggles my mind because I never would have thought, you know, Yoda pulling out a lightsaber and started fighting people. That was just pretty awesome. My third least favorite Star Wars film would be Return of the Jedi. The Ewoks never sat right with me. I don't know why. I just never really liked them. And then in the new editions on the Blu-ray versions, now they have blinking eyes, which was done by CGI effects. It's just even weirder. So it just gets knocked down a little bit more. Then my third favorite Star Wars movie would be A New Hope. That's the one that started it all. And that's it's a great movie. It's good versus evil, Darth Vader, Luke Skywalker, Obi-Wan Kenobi. I love A New Hope. My second favorite one is Revenge of the Sith. Revenge of the Sith is probably one of, is right there with my favorites as a Star Wars movie since, you know, Empire Strikes Back. But Revenge of the Sith, I think George Lucas knew how he wanted to end the prequels, but he didn't really know how to start, and he didn't really know the middle of it, but he knew how to end it, because Revenge of the Sith is really, really great. I like it. It is the best movie of the prequels. But the best Star Wars movie of all time is Empire Strikes Back. There's no question, there's no debate on that. Empire Strikes Back is the best. It's also the best sequel of all time. I don't care if you want to say Godfather 2 or Two Towers or any other sequel, Empire Strikes Back is the best sequel of all time. It set the mold for what sequels should be. It took everything about A New Hope and made it better. So Star Wars Empire Strikes Back is the best Star Wars movie of all time. So there's no better time to be a Star Wars fan. I mean, you have the new movies coming out, starting out in 2015. J.J. Abrams just released the first cast photo. iTunes is celebrating Star Wars Month with all these Star Wars apps. There's so many games and things like that. I mean, it's nothing better than being a Star Wars fan right now. It's exciting again. We're going to get a whole bunch of new movies and a whole new books and comics and everything like that. So it's going to be great.
You dead! You didn't help me! Now I'm dead! So you go get it. I'm a force ghost now. I'll spend all my time haunting you. You. All you. Gonna learn today.
Well, until next time. Bye.